Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about Chandragupta Maurya. Through this lesson, we are going to discuss about previous questions of Chandragupta Maurya and some basic history points of Chandragupta Maurya. And the third thing, we are providing a short notes regarding to this video in our Telegram channel. If you want these notes, you can join in Telegram channel and you can download it. Let's begin the class. The Chandragupta Maurya was a founder of Mauryan dynasty. This is a previous question also. Who was a founder of Mauryan dynasty? Chandragupta Maurya. There is a lot of discussions regarding to the Chandragupta Maurya time period. Basically, some standard textbooks, we are revising the time period of Chandragupta Maurya as 324 to 300 BC. You just remember this time period also. Now, coming to that Chandragupta Maurya background, there is a lot of confusion regarding to that Chandragupta Maurya background because we have a various resources and various information from that resources. And apart from that all resources, we are only discussing here three resources which are very important for our exams like SSE or RRB or different exams. The first resource regarding to the Chandragupta Maurya background, that is a Buddhist tradition books or Buddhist resource. According to the Buddhist stories or Buddhist books, Chandragupta Maurya father was killed by unknown people and after that Chandragupta Maurya brought up by his maternal uncle. And his maternal uncle joined Chandragupta Maurya in a famous university, which is also known as the oldest university in the world, Takshila. Right? There is a two questions we are covered here. The founder of Mauryan dynasty, Chandragupta Maurya, the oldest university in the world is Takshila. And according to the Greek resources, Chandragupta Maurya identity is completely unknown. And Chandragupta Maurya is belongs to that one of that Mahajanapada, one of that Mahajanapada or tribal group in northern part of India. And due to disturbance of Alexander invasion and his death, because of Alexander invasion and Alexander death and whatever the disturbances are happened in northern India, and the advantage is used by Chandragupta Maurya, he started largest campaigns in North India and he fought with so many kings and finally he established this dynasty. And here we are believed that according to Greek resources, and Chandragupta Maurya took advantage of disturbance which is happened in northern part of India due to invention of Alexander and his followers. And the third one, according to the Jain text, Chandragupta Maurya with the help of Chanakya, or who is also called as Kautilya, defeated Nandas and he established a powerful dynasty in India, that is a Mauryan dynasty. Regarding to from these three resources and whatever that information is there, basically we can conclude it. How we can conclude it? That is Chandragupta Maurya, and after the invasion of Alexander and with the help of Chanakya or Kautilya, he attacked Nandas and he suppressed Nandas dynasty, and finally he established a powerful, well-fledged dynasty, that is a Mauryans. The next one, coming to the personal information regarding to the Chandragupta Maurya married Helena. Chandragupta Maurya married Helena, and who was the daughter of Seleucus Nicator. And his son, Chandragupta Maurya's son, Bindusara. These two questions is also previous questions, and Bindusara was a son of, or Chandragupta Maurya's son, that is a Bindusara, and his wife Helena, and who was a daughter of Seleucus Nicator. And coming to that Chandragupta Maurya administration, now you can see here Chandragupta Maurya is a first king who unified India under his rule. And this sentence makes some sense because, and whatever the great rulers are there in Mauryan dynasty like Ashoka and Bindusara, these people are only ruled or only permitted their areas in the northern parts of India. But Chandragupta Maurya is the only one person who ruled North India along with South India, North India as well as the South Indian parts like Takshashila. And we have a one more place is there, Indraprasthana. And the next one we have a Mauryan dynasty's capital, that is a Pataliputra. And one more part of South India, that is a Ujjain and as well as a Sanchi. The Ujjain and Sanchi places are belongs to that right now Madhya Pradesh, and Pataliputra right now located in Bihar, and Takshila is not a part of India right now, and Indraprastha nowadays it is known as that Delhi. So these all areas are ruled by Mauryan dynasty, but Chandragupta Maurya ruled north to South India. The next one, he is the first king who done treaty with a foreign king. And the foreign king name is Seleucus Nicator. As I said in that above sentence, Seleucus Nicator daughter Helena married Chandragupta Maurya. And as well as Seleucus Nicator done treaty with the Chandragupta Maurya. These two are highly appreciable regarding to the Chandragupta Maurya. He is the first king and who ruled unified India. And the second thing is the first king who done treaty with the foreign king. The next one. Chandragupta Maurya followed Jainism. His religion is Jainism. And the second thing, along with Jain monk Bhadrabahu, Chandragupta Maurya, along with Jain king Bhadrabahu, he went to Karnataka. And after that, by Sallekana system, which is very important Jainism, fasting up to the death. By Sallekana system, he died in Shravana Belgula, which is located in Karnataka. Right? And these are the information regarding to the Chandragupta Maurya. And if you like this video, please subscribe and share. And if you have any queries, please comment below. And thank you.